As we celebrate the anniversary of our graduation from high school, it is fitting to think about the history of the town we grew up in and its impact on the rest of this country. Originally named Beresport, Catasauqua was first settled in 1805. Then, Welsh immigrant David Thomas relocated to the area about 30 years later with a vision that would open the community's manufacturing floodgates by building an ironworks. And on July 4, 1840, his Crane Ironworks became the first commercially successful anthracite iron furnace in America. More than any other single achievement up to that time in history, it signaled the beginning of the Industrial Revolution in America. Remembered as the father of Catasauqua, Thomas renamed his adopted community Craneville after his former employer in Wales. Then, in 1854, the town was formally titled Catasauqua, from the Lenni Lenape language meaning dry or thirsty ground. The success of Crane Iron spawned the growth of other industries in Catasauqua and changed the lives of Americans across the United States forever. The anthracite iron industry had triggered a wave of industrial innovation that made Catasauqua famous and made many Catasauquans rich. By the time the 20th century opened, Catasauqua was one of the most prosperous towns in the United States, with a higher percentage of millionaires than anywhere else in the nation. The most visible remainder of Catasauqua's past are its mansions and other elaborate buildings of that era. Also of historic note, George Taylor, signer of the Declaration of Independence, built a stone house in 1768 in what is now the borough of Catasauqua. Today, that house is a National Historic Landmark, a showpiece of the community's rich historical heritage. In a side note, in 1917, while many of the young men of the town served in World War I, Catasauqua became the first community in the United States to raise $1 million in war bonds, earning it the nickname the Million Dollar Town. Although the financial success of the members of the Catasauqua High School's Class of 64 may not measure up to the town's historic highs, we are certainly a successful group. Most of us are in good health, and many of us are experiencing the special joys of children and their children. Also, many of us manage to retire early, and the rest are nearing the ends of our careers. And finally, over November 6th and 7th, 2009, many of us were able to gather together to celebrate the 45th anniversary of our high school graduation.
Well, you go home with me tonight.
Welcome to our 45th Catasauqua reunion. Hope we all have a great time, and I'm so glad that you're here.
Ready or not, here I come. Gee, that used to be such fun.
Apple pizza, pumpkin pie.
Prop. I'm here to fill out bills, you know, at his urging to see whether this darn thing works.
I made them on a Monday and my heart stood still. Did you run, run, run? Did you run, run? Somebody told me that his name was Bill. Did you run, run?
I had some trouble with my baby, so I had my fortune read. I had some trouble with my baby, and this is what the gypsy said. The gypsy cried.
I wanna walk you home. Really let me walk you home. I want to walk you home. Really let me walk you home. You look so good to me. Ooh, I wish I was a lucky guy. I'll walk you right on down the aisle. I love the way you walk. I love you.
Very appreciative of Sam's letting us use your establishment to make fools of ourselves. And I also.
You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, yeah. Girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
Did you go home with Sam last night?
I'm not jealous! That's not a secret.
That's bad, right? We're not going there.
Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this. My- three times.
And you foul dribble.
Three times. That's all I was allowed to do. Well, you see, that's what always happened. It flew right into my face. And I was wearing glasses. I do want you to know that I was number 44, which is the number of our current president.
Five more years! Yay!
Yeah. I heard a home run.
request from Dougie Miller, because he's always through the area, he told me, on the third week of October. Now, why he knows where he'll be 5 years from now, I don't know.
I wish everyone in 2014 good health, peace over the land, and that we all look the same as we do in 2009. That was my line.
You know that. Okay, and I'm hoping that we see classmates here that have not been coming to any of our reunions.
And we see everybody that was here in 2009 back again in 2014.
Right.
I hope to see you at the next one. Yes, please come.
There is me. Go around me.
I think, personally, that the next reunion should be in Whitefish, Montana.
Oh, I vote for that.
Up there.
Let's walk down memory lane once more together. Let's talk about the way it was back then. And if we really try, I know that you and I will capture all those happy times again.
Once more, let's sing the songs that made us happy. Songs that sometimes made us shy.